वेलकम टू subramani.com. वन क्वेश्चन विच पीपल कीप आस्किंग मी इज आई गॉट सम एक्स्ट्रा मनी, शुड आई रीपे माई लोन और शुड आई इन्वेस्ट दिस अमाउंट, राइट? दिस अ वेरी फ्रीक्वेंटली आस्क क्वेश्चन एंड माई आंसर हैज ऑलवेज बीन डिपेंड्स ऑन वेदर यू आर आस्किंग मी फॉर 1 year, 3 year, 5 years और 25 years, राइट? सो इट डिपेंड्स ऑन दैट, बिकॉज इफ आई आस्क यू टू इन्वेस्ट द मनी एंड द मार्केट फॉल 60% इन 1 year एंड इट लुक लाइक अ डिजास्ट्रस डिसीजन. इफ आई आस्क यू टू रीपे द लोन एंड द मार्केट गोज अप बाई 60% इन 1 year, अगेन इट वुड बी अ डिजास्ट्रस डिसीजन. So I am very clear that if you are asking me a 25-year question, it's very clear that you should be investing the money, because I dare say the return that you get on equities over a 20-year period or a 25-year period should be far greater than the housing loan interest that you're paying. Maybe you're paying 7.5, 8% today or 8.10 or something like this, and your equity returns could be in the region of 10.5, 11%, maybe 12%. So there is a 2-3% alpha to be made. But we have no clue what the future will hold, and to judge me on the basis of what is going to happen in the future is ridiculously wrong, because I am not here to guess what will happen. But if over a long period of time, yes, equity should give you better returns. So depending on how much of loan you have, because largely we Indians think of loan as a burden. Now suppose you have a 50 lakh rupee or a 70 lakh rupee loan, right? So 70,000 per month is what you were paying or what you are paying, and you've been paying for last 4-5 years and you're very comfortably paying this amount. So now you're very confident that you can now increase it to say 90,000 per month, which means another 20,000 bump up is possible for you to do. Because between you and your wife, you're earning about 50-55 lakhs a year. So this is hardly 1.5 years of your income, gross income. That is the loan. So it should not bother you. What happens is somebody in your family, maybe your dad would be saying, you know, I took only 6 lakhs loan, you're taking 70 lakhs loan, it's too high. But you need to understand that when your dad took a 6 lakh loan, maybe his income was maybe just 1 lakh a year. And he was taking 6 years loan, and your mother was a housewife. Whereas you and your wife, between the two of you, maybe you're earning 30-35 lakhs and she's earning about 25 lakhs or 20 lakhs. So 55 lakhs is what you're earning. 70 lakhs is a loan, right? So the loan amount is not too high. So there is absolutely no hurry to repay. You can repay. There is nothing wrong in repaying also. But largely we wouldn't know what to do. But this fear that कल कुछ हो जाएगा kind of a thing, I don't think anything like that happens. Don't worry about what could happen, right? For that there is always term insurance in case you think you will die. Make sure that both of you have term insurance. Make sure that you have adequate medical insurance. Make sure that you have critical illness, especially if you understand how critical illness operates. If you don't understand how critical illness operates, learn how it operates. After that, if you still don't understand, don't buy it. If you understand, buy it, right? So what are the advantages, disadvantages? One more reason to not to repay is, suppose you bought this house 5-6 years ago and you're paying the EMI perfectly, your HDFC is very happy with what you're doing, so there is nothing for you to really worry about. So this loan repayment, you shouldn't do the loan repayment, because your wife is already saying that let us buy a bigger house. So if in another 5 years time you're going to buy a bigger house, there is absolutely no point in repaying this loan here and then going back and asking for a fresh loan and paying fresh processing charges. 5 more years let this loan continue, don't repay in a lump sum. Maybe you want to do 50, instead of 70,000 per month, you want to do 75,000 per month, that's okay. But don't make a lump sum repayment. Does not make sense, because after 5 years, you are again going to seek a loan for buying a bigger house. By selling off this house, you're going to pay processing charges again. Whereas if the same loan becomes a bigger loan, you won't pay processing charges. So you save all that. If you do not know whether, if you're sure that your last house has been bought, you're already 52 years of age or 53 years of age, you're not going to buy one more house, then you're going to deal with it very differently. Then you repay the loan only when you retire. The day you retire, you get your lump sums. On that day, you go and repay whatever is the loan, right? These are different ways of dealing with the loan. And definitely, if there's a long term to go, And you're sure you'll not kill yourself into saying, oh God, I made such a poor decision in 1 year or 3 years or 5 years, then by all means you should invest. But if you can't make up your mind and you've got, say, 10 lakhs extra that you have, do what is exactly the midway path. Use 3 lakhs to repay the loan. 3 lakhs you go and enjoy yourself, because the money that you get should also be for enjoying. And another 3 lakhs you put into your retirement fund. So that way you will be happy, because if the market were to go down, if you put the whole 10 lakhs, the market were to go down, your wife will say, hey, at least we could have enjoyed, I could have bought some jewelry, something I could have bought. See, the whole thing is lost in the market. You know it will be recovered, but then there is a ticker which comes every day telling her what happened, that Infosys broke down, or, you know, things like that. So all that can add to your stress. So partially sab kuch karo. You can put this, if you're going to put this money in a bank FD and keep it there, then it makes no sense. Then you might as well repay the loan, because your loan amount, the interest on loan that you're paying has to be above the bank interest that you're getting. So if your bank is giving you 6% return and you're paying 9.5-10% interest on your housing loan, it doesn't make sense at all to keep an SB account or even in an FD. It does not make sense at all. You might as well repay the loan, because remember, if you had borrowed this money from HDFC and you have repaid over 10 years, and if you need more money, you can always go and say, I need more money. You can always take money for your children going abroad, right? Those are the reasons why you would require money. You will be allowed to draw over and above the loan that you have been given. So that is not really so much of a problem. Understand the power of compounding. The longer that the money stays invested, the better returns. So don't disturb investments to repay the loan. As in, when you run out of, when you are retiring and you get a lump sum, that is a good time to be repaying the loan, right? If you have not taken it at a very young age, let it continue. You can always say, okay, I'm going to retire next week. I got 3 lakhs outstanding out of my PF or gratuity, whatever I'm getting, I'm going to repay a part of this loan. So read this, hear this. I will give you the link below. Read that also. So whenever you're talking to anybody who says, "Arey, if instead of repaying you had reinvested, this is what would have happened," or somebody saying, "Good that you repaid during COVID times, it was so difficult, people were not able to pay their installment," that is also wrong. So find a via media in all this and then take a decision. Don't jump to conclusions. No, there's no great hurry. Thank you.